गणानां त्वा गणपतिं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पतान शृण्वन्नुतिभिः सीदसादनं श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। डियर् फ्रेण्ड्स्, वी हेव् टु रीड् दिस् 13th मन्त्र इन् द सेकेण्ड् वल्ली आफ् सेकेण्ड् अध्याय। So that is Nityo Nityanam, the 12th mantra we completed in the last class, that is Eko Vashi Sarvabhutantaratma Ekam Rupam Bahudhayah Karoti, that mantra we completed. The context is, we are discussing the nature of Atman. In the earlier mantras we have seen that Atma is present equally in all the Upadhis. All these Upadhis may be there, all the diverse Upadhis, and just as one Surya, one sun who is throwing his light on all the things, good, bad and ugly, and then equally shines on all of them. So similarly, this Atma Chaitanya is there, which is shining on all the things, which is illumining all the things. Then again, Atma at the same time, it is untouched by all these things, untouched by the karma of all the beings in this world. That is Atma's Asangata. Asangata is that which is untouched, untainted by any of these things. So that we saw in the earlier mantra. Then again, we also saw Eko Vashi Sarvabhutantaratma, that is one who can who realizes this Atman. He is the man who attains that bliss. He is the man who knows, who attains that bliss. So that is what we saw in the earlier mantra. So this mantra is in continuation of the earlier one. So let us read this. Nityo Nityanam Chetanaschetananam Eko Bahunam Yo Vidadhati Kaman तमात्मस्थं येन उपश्यन्ति धीराः तेषां शान्तिः शाश्वती नेतरेषां। सो दिस् मन्त्र आल्सो सेस् दोस् हू अटैन् आर् दोस् हू रियलैज् दिस् आत्मन् द सेम् द लास्ट् लैन् इस् द सेम् द लास्ट् टू लैन्स् आर् द सेम् इन् द अर्लियर् मन्त्र अण्ड् आल्सो इन् दिस् मन्त्र। तम आत्मस्थम ये अनुपश्यन्ति धीराः तेषां सुखं शाश्वतं नेतरेषां। ते अर्लियर मंत्र सेड सुखम, बट दिस मंत्र सेज तेषां शान्तिः। सो दट इज द ओनली डिफरेंस। सो दोस हू अटेन दिस आत्मा, दे आर द पीपल हू आर हैप्पी। एंड व्हाट इज द नेचर ऑफ द आत्मा, दिस मंत्र अगेन इज एक्सप्लेनिंग। नित्यः अनित्यानां चेतनः चेतनानां, इफ यू सी दैट नित्यो नित्यानां नित्यः अनित्यानां, दट नित्यः बिकम्स नित्यो, इन दट संधि इट बिकम्स नित्यो। नित्यो नित्यानां इज नित्यः अनित्यानां, चेतनः चेतनानां, इट डज नॉट से अचेतनानां, देयर इज अ डिफरेंस, आई विल एक्सप्लेन। नित्यः अनित्यानां, चेतनः चेतनानां, एकः बहूनां बिकम्स एको बहूनां, यः विदधाति कामान, यः विदधाति कामान, यः कामान विदधाति। Then the last two lines are the same. Tam atmastham ye anupashyanti dhiraha tesham shantihi shashvati netaresham. Tam atmastham, that particular atman, that particular thing, that particular brahman, atmastham, which is in your own self, then ye anupashyanti, yaha ye dhiraha, that is those dhiraha, those wise men who anupashyanti, who are able to see that, who are able to cognize that, tesham shantihi, this shanti, or this equanimity, this shanti, again here we can take it as sukham only, that bliss only. Satyam, jnanam, anantam, satchid, ananda, these three things are there. So that ananda is something which is referred to here. Tesham shantihi, that is that ananda. Shashwati, shashwati shantihi na itaresham. Tesham shantihi na itaresham. So that is it. So what is this nityaha anityanam? Nityaha, we know what is this nitya. Nitya is something which is unchanging, which is eternal, which is always there, which whose existence cannot be negated, whose existence cannot be negated in the past, present and future. त्रिकालाबाध्यत्वम इट इज कॉल्ड त्रिकालाबाध्यत्वम मीन्स इट दट विच कैनॉट बी नेगेटेड इन ऑल द थ्री टेंसेस प्रेजेंट पास्ट फ्यूचर टेंसेस एंड विच मीन्स दट इट इज बियॉन्ड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ टाइम टाइम इट सेल्फ इज ए सॉर्ट ऑफ क्रिएशन टाइम वॉट इज दिस टाइम मायाकल्पित देश काल कलन उज्जृंभितम दट इज वाट वी सी इन दिस दक्षिणामूर्ति स्तोत्रम मायाकल्पित देश कालन कलन वैचित्र्य चित्रीकृतम दट इज द लाइन सो देश काल कलन दिस कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ देश काल एट्सेट्रा दिस इज अगेन देश मीन्स प्लेस द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ दिस ईस्ट वेस्ट नॉर्थ साउथ ऑल दीज थिंग्स देन अगेन दिस इज अगेन ए कल्पना ओनली What is east with reference to sun? There is no east or west or anything with reference to sun. There is no east or west anything with reference to Brahman. There is something with reference to us. We call a particular thing east. We are calling something west. We are calling something else that. So with reference to us, we are calling something as past. We are referring to something as present. With reference to us, we are calling something as future. But with reference to Brahman, there is no such thing as past, present and future because everything is just a manifestation. That is his point of view. From Brahman's point of view. So this is what is called Nitya. That is Trikala Abadhyam. That is something which cannot be negated in all the three things. So that is referring to what in this, if we take these three things as the characteristics of Brahman, that is Sat, Chit and Anandam as the characteristics of Brahman, this particular thing is referring to that Sat component, Sat, that which exists always. Anityanam, Nityaha Anityanam. In all these changing things, Anityam is all these changing things. What are these things which change? All the names and forms, they keep on changing. In the universe, you find so much of diversity. And in this diversity, in all these things, there are five components. In the last class also, I think I told this shloka once or twice. Asti bhati priyam rupam namacha iti amsha panchakam. Asti bhati priyam. These three. Asti is sat. Bhati, that is intelligence, chit. Priyam, that is ananda. Sat, chit, ananda. Then rupam, nama, the form and name. These five things are there in all the things. The first three, they are the characteristics of the Brahman. The next two are the characteristics of Jagat. Adhyatrayam Brahmarupam Jagadrupam Tatodvayam. So that is the next line. So Adhyatrayam Brahmarupam. So that is the first three, Sat, Chit and Ananda, these three are the components which belong to Brahman. Only name and form, they are changing. They keep on changing. That is what is called Jagat. Gachati iti Jagat. Gachati means it is always in a state of flux. It is in a state of change. So, Nityaha Anityanam, in all these changing things, this is something which is unchanging. Then, Chetanaha Chetananam. So, here it is not said Chetanaha Achetananam. Strictly speaking, Chetanaha Achetananam only. Apart from Brahman, there is no other Chit. So Chetanaha is one and one only. All other things, they look like Chetanas. So that is why, because these things, they look like Chetanas, it is said Chetanaha Chetananam. In all those things which look like sentient, this is the actual sentience or intelligence in all these things which appear to be intelligent, which appear to be sentient. So that is the meaning here. Chetanaha Chetananam. So earlier Nityaha, that Sat component is told. In this Chetana, that Chit component is being told. Then, Yekaha Bahunam Yo Vidadhati Kaman. Yekaha Bahunam. This is one and one only. This non-dual self, this non-dual Brahman is one. Then, Bahunam Vidadhati Kaman. Bahunam, for so many beings. For so many beings means, what are all these beings? All these beings which see diversity. You and I, we are all beings. And hordes of beings, a multitude of beings all around us, these are the people who see diversity, isn't it? So that is why we are, in a sense, multitude. We are also seeing multitude. We are multitude because we are seeing multitude. We are Bahu because we are also seeing Bahu or diversity. Bahu means many. We are seeing Bahu, that is many, because we are many because we are also seeing many. That is it. So, Yekaha Bahunam, among those who, for all those who see this diversity, And the one who does not see diversity, who is an ekatva darshi, one who is seeing the non-dual self, he will not have any kama, he will not have any desire. Only those who see diversity, they see diversity because they perceive themselves as limited. They perceive themselves as delimited, parichinna. So that is why they see everything as different, everything as something different, finite. So that is the reason. So ekaha bahunam yo vidadhati kaman. One who sees unity, he will not have any desires. One who sees diversity, he will have desires. Because he sees diversity, I see something new, I want it. I see something else, I see somebody who is richer than me. So then I want some more riches. So like that, when I see diversity only, I need more. So here we are seeing this ekaha, this one thing only is appearing to be giving all the kaman. Kama means desires. Ekaha bahunam, to all these people, yaha kaman vidadhati. Kaman means, kama is desire. So all these kama, all these desires are, this is the one which is dispensing all these desires. Vidadhati means prayachati or dispenses, gives. In that sense it is used. Dadhati, the root is dha. Dha is dharana poshanayo. Dha means to bear, to hold, to sustain, to nourish. Dharana and poshana. Dharana is to hold, to sustain. Then poshana means to nourish. So in these two senses, this word, this root dha is used. Dha, the verb is dadhati. Dadhati means it bears, it sustains, it nourishes. So that is the meaning. So there is an upasarga here, vi. Vi dadhati. So the meaning is prayachati, it gives. Shankaracharya is giving the meaning prayachati. So that which dispenses all these desires. Because these desires are only for those who see the multitude, who see diversity. Desires are not there for somebody who sees unity, isn't it? So that is why, so for all those who see diversity, this Brahman which is giving all the desires. In what form? On one hand we are saying Brahma is Asanga, and then again we are saying Brahma is giving all the desires. How? So through, in the form of this creator Brahman, in the form of this empirical or transactional level reality, transactional level Brahman. So at the transactional level, we are conceptualizing one God form, isn't it? That we call some Ishvara, you call it Hiranyagarbha, and in that Hiranyagarbha only all these divine forms are, whatever divine form is there, it is manifesting in that only. So these are the thing. This is the level at which he gives the so-called desires. All these desires are fulfilled at this level. But the Supreme Brahman is Asanga. It is something which is untouched, which is beyond all these things. So that we have to always remember. It is not the Supreme Brahman who is giving you all the desires. Through the medium of Maya, through the medium of that Ishvara, these your desires are fulfilled. That we have to see. Then, tam atmastham, these lines we have read earlier, atmastham, that which is there in you, ye janaha, ye dhiraha anupashyanti, those who are able to realize, tesham shantihi, for them that bliss is there, na itaresham, shantihi, that bliss, these are the people who have that bliss and not others. So, let us read the bhashyam, nityaha avinashi,
Anityanam vinashinam.
So for all these changing things, changing nama, rupa, this is the thing which is the eternal unchanging component. So a ghata breaks, but then it is in the form of mrut. The mrut also disappears. It is in its karana, it resolves into its karana. Then that karana apaha, that is water, that also disappears. That resolves into its karana agni. So likewise, it goes and goes and goes, something else exists, is always there. The word exists, it is always there. That is that which is commonly going across all the things, all the beings, all the things. So anityanam vinashinam madhye nityaha, this is one eternal thing. Then
chetanaha chetananam, chetaitrunam brahmadinam praninam.
Okay, chetanaha chetananam, chetanaha, that which is the thinking component, that which is enabling everybody to think. This is same thing we say in Gayatri Mantra, Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhiyo Yonah Prachodayat. What is the meaning of Dhiyo Yonah Prachodayat? Yaha Naha Dhiyaha Prachodayat, that which is enabling our dhiyaha. Dhi means buddhi. That which is enabling all our buddhis to think. That which is impelling all our buddhis to think. So that is what is dhiyaha yo naha prachodaya. That which is enlightening, not enlightening, that is that which is enabling this buddhi to think. Or that which is illumining, that which is illumining our buddhis. So that is the meaning of dhiyaha yo naha prachodayat. So that is that chetana. The same chetana, that chaitanya only is the thing. Chetaitrunam, brahmadinam, praninam. All these things, other things like, other beings like Brahma. So here Shankaracharya, you see the use of the words, brahmadinam, praninam. This Brahma, or the creator Brahma as we call it, creator Brahma, as we call him rather. So because this creator Brahma is in masculine gender. Only the supreme Brahman is in neuter gender. Creator Brahma is in masculine gender. So this Brahma, Vishnu, Ishvara, etc., etc., Dindra, Varuna, Vayu, all these things are certain manifestations. They represent certain cosmic functions. So that is what we have to see. So these are again Prani. Brahma again is a Prani. Brahmadinam, Praninam. And who are they? Chetaitrunam. Chetaita. Chetaita means Chetanam is intelligence or say consciousness, let us say. Chetaita is one who directs, one who impels you, one who impels your thinking, that is Chetaita. One who enables your mind to think, that is Chetaita. Chetaitrunam is Shashti Bahuvachanam. Shashti Vibhakti is say possessive case, Chetaitrunam. The other day I was grappling for that word, Shashti Vibhakti, English word is possessive case. Okay, Chetaitrunam is the Shashti Bahuvachanam of Chetaita. For all these people, Chetaitrunam, Brahmadinam, Praninam, all these words are in Shashti Bahuvachanam. That is, in the case of all these Pranis like that creator Brahma, who are again Chetaitas. Chetaitas. Chetaita, English, yes, Chetaitas, plural. So, for all these people, Chetaitrunam, for all those people who give us direction, who give us that thinking capacity, for all these people, then who is the, what is this Chaitanyam behind all these things? The Chaitanyam behind all these things is that of Brahman only. So that is the thing here. Chetananam, Chetaitrunam, Brahmadinam, this is the Chetanaha. For all these Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara, etc., they are not Chetana by themselves. They are getting their Chetana, they are getting their intelligence from the Supreme Brahman. That Chit component is from the Supreme Brahman only. That Chit component only is manifesting as Brahma. That Chit component only is manifesting as Vishnu. That Chit only is manifesting as Rudra. All these things are manifestations from that Chit only. And these things independently, they are also appearing as though they are Chetaitas. Chetaitrunam, Brahmadinam, Praninam. Then an example is being given. Agni Nimittamiva Dahakatvam Anagninam Udakadinam Atma Chaitanya Nimittamiva Chetaitrutvam Anyesham. So Anyesham means of all these people, of all these things, of all these other things, Chetaitrutvam. Chetaitrutvam means the ability to manifest as intelligence. Chetaitrutvam, Chetaita, the state of being a Chetaita is called Chetaitrutvam. It is a bhave, that is a noun form. So, Anyesham, for all these things, for all other things like Brahma, Vishnu, Rudra, etc., etc., Chetaitrutvam, that is the ability to manifest as the impellers of intelligence, as illuminers, all that thing is because of that Supreme Brahman. And the example given is, Agni Nimittamiva Dahakatvam Anagninam Udakadinam. You take some water and heat it up. If you take water and heat it up, water also boils. And if you put your hand or if you pour it on yourself, it gives you boils. So then where has this come from? This has come from Agni only. And Agni is not seen in that. Agni is not seen physically in the water, but then it is felt. So this Agni Nimittamiva Dahakatvam, this Dahakatvam, Dahakatvam is the burning capacity. Burning capacity, anagninam udakadinam, udaka adinam, udakam etc. Udakam is water, water etc. Which are anagni, that is different from agni. These are all different from agni, but then they get their dahakatvam or burning capacity from agni. that is being by being in contact with Agni. Agni nimittam eva. Agni nimittam is because of Agni. It is due to that Agni only. Agni nimittam eva dahakatvam anagnina mudakadinam atma chaitanya nimittam eva chetaitrutvam anyesham. This chetaitrutvam, this ability of all other things to impel, to appear as intelligent things and then as though they are illumining all of us, it is because of the chaitanya nimittam. Chaitanya nimittam is because of the, it is due to that chaitanyam of Supreme Brahman. Just as in the case of Agni, because of contact with that Agni, all other things are getting that dahakatvam. Because these things are again illumined by all this Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara are illumined by that Supreme Brahman, Supreme Chaitanyam. These things are appearing as though they are Chetaitas. This Chetaitrutvam is because of that. So that is it. Kincha,
Sa
Sarvajnaha Sarveshwaraha, Kaminam Samsarinam, Karmanu Rupam, Kaman Karma Phalani, Swanugraha Nimittanscha Kaman, Yaha Yeko Bahunam Anekesham, Anayasena Vidadhati, Prayachati Ityetat. So now we are coming to this Sat and Chit have been explained. Now we are coming to this Ananda component. So what is this Ananda component? Kincha, moreover, Sa Sarvajnaha Sarveshwaraha. That particular all-knowing Sarveshwara. So here we have to take by Lakshana. By Lakshana means by because of the context, we have to take not the Supreme Brahman. We have to take that Creator Brahman who is in charge of all this. Say something like allocation of duties. If you have got 100 people under you, you have to divide the tasks and you have to divide them duties. And depending on their work, you have to allot you have to give some rewards or punishments. So this is something like an administrative work. So all this we have to say, refer to that administrative God here, not the Supreme Brahman. So the Sarvagnaha Sarveshwaraha, Kaminam Samsarinam, for all these people who are samsaris, those who are in this transmigration cycle, for all these people who are having this kamas, kamas means desires, then he gives them their, he dispenses all those things. So it does not mean that he, whatever you want, he will give. That is again, that is the word is karmanu rupam kaman karma phalani. Karmanu rupam, that is depending on your karma only. Depending on your karma, that is karma anurupam means in accordance with the karma. Anurupam is in accordance with. Karmanurupam, kaman karma phalani. This kama does not mean that if wishes were to be horses, beggars would ride on them. That is, there is a proverb in English. So you desire a kingdom, okay, you will get a kingdom. Everybody will desire a kingdom. Then who will be the king? Then who will be the subject? So there will be no subject at all. So then that will be a strange situation. So depending on your karma only, this karma phala will come. And when you use the word kama, kama means is referring to that karma phala, that is the result of the karma which you have done. In addition to that, he gives some bonus. That is what Shankaracharya is saying. Kaman karma phalani, swanugraha nimittanscha kaman. So he also anugraha nimittan, swa anugraha nimittanscha kaman. Don't think that he is just a mechanic, something like a clerk who is just giving you your paycheck. He is not only a clerk, he is not a clerk, but he is a boss. He is not a clerk. He is capable of giving you some more, some Diwali gift or something like that, some bonus he is capable of giving. So that is the meaning here. Karmanurupam kaman karma phalani, swanugraha nimittanscha kaman, swa anugraha nimittan. Those he himself wants to give. That is, seeing the good behavior of some people, he wants to give him some more favorable, treatment. So he will take him and then give birth in some yogis, yoginam gehe. So he will give birth in a yogi's family. So something like that. In whatever manner he wants to reward him, he will reward them in accordance with his own, compassion also. Swa anugraha. Anugraha means out of compassion, he will further give something more. Swanugraha nimittanscha kaman yaha ekaha bahunam anekesham. Bahunam means anekesham. For all these people, for all the beings, for so many beings. Anayasena vidadhati prayachati. Without any effort. Anayasena means without any effort. prayachati, he gives. Vidadhati prayachati. That is, bahunam, the interpretation by one commentator is, those who see this diversity, bahunam, those who see this diversity, only they are interested in all these desires. Those who see unity, they are not interested in the desires. Those who see this atma, aikatvam, they will not have any desires. Those who see diversity and those who feel themselves as delimited, only they will have all these desires. And those desires are fulfilled by the creator Brahma, depending on their deeds, good or bad deeds, depending on their karmas, he will give you the result. Vidadhati prayachati iti etat. Then tam atmastham
ye anupashyanti dhiraha
tesham shantihi uparatihi shashvati nitya
swatma bhutaiva syat
na itaresham anevam vidhanam okay. These two lines are the same which we saw earlier also in the earlier mantra. Tam atmastham, that particular entity, that Sat Chit and Ananda, which is there in your own self, Atmastham, ye anupashyanti dhiraha, ye dhiraha, those who are able to gather up their minds, dhiraha, dhira, the meaning of dhira is dhiyam rati iti dhiraha, that is dhiyam buddhim rati grunhati, one who is able to focus his whole attention, one who is able to focus his mind, he is called a dhira. One, he is able to focus his mind, concentrate his mind on a thing, he is called a dhira. Dhiyam rati, grunhati, iti dhira. One who is able to control, one who is able to focus, one who is able to concentrate in a very concentrated way, he can meditate. So that is the meaning of, all that is the meaning of dhira. So dhira, ye anupashyanti, those who are able to see that, tesham shantihi uparatihi. Shanti means, the meaning given here is uparati. Uparati means, because they have, by virtue of giving up, they are getting this shanti. By virtue of, by viveka, by sheer viveka, that is by sheer discrimination, they have given up asking all these desires. They have seen the futility of all these desires. They have seen the, ephemeral or impermanent nature of all these desires, and thus they have given up. Tyagena eke amrutattva manashuhu, that line also we can recall. Tyagena eke amrutattva manashuhu, that is, you derive happiness not only by having a vishaya, you derive happiness by discarding a vishaya. Not out of frustration, not that sour grapes story, that fox and the sour grapes story, not like the fox which jumps for the sour grapes and then for the grapes and then it says, no, the grapes are sour and goes away, not like that. This our vairagya is not that sour grapes vairagya. So this vairagya is born out of viveka, born out of discrimination, proper analysis of what is yourself, what is the nature of the Supreme Self. So by proper analysis only you are giving up all these ephemeral things, and you are not in that predicament of fox and sour grapes. So that is it. Shantihi uparatihi. Uparati is that, uparati actually means withdrawal. Withdrawal, that is tyaga, in that particular sense is tyaga. And tyaga gives you more ananda than that vishaya ananda. Uparatihi shashvati nitya swatma bhutaiva syat. Swatma bhutaiva syat means that becomes your own nature. That is, that shanti, that uparati is swatma bhuta. That is your own nature. You will feel it as your own nature. That ananda, you feel it as your own nature. Suppose you, if we can practice it also. Suppose you give some little bit of dhanam. When you give some dhanam, there is some amount of happiness. There are two things which happens when you give dhanam. The first, maybe in the beginning, you will have some type of spiritual pride. There is what is called a spiritual pride. Yes, I am a holy man. I am giving this. So that is the level of spiritual pride. So that also we have to overcome. Slowly we have to overcome that spiritual pride. And then you have to do it as a matter of duty. This is my duty. So that, over a period of time when you start doing it, then you yourself have some happiness. You have some inexplicable happiness when you give, when you abandon a thing, when you discard a thing, you will have more happiness than when you have a thing. So that is what is swatma bhuta iva syat. It becomes your own nature. Na itaresham anevam vidhanam. For all those people who want desires, for all those people who see this diversity and multitude, who want this Vishaya Ananda. Vishaya Ananda means happiness from objects. Vishaya Ananda. Vishaya is object. Ananda is happiness. Vishaya Ananda is different from Brahmananda. So here, by Tyaga, this man is happy, and not by having these Vishayas, by having these objects. So that is the line here. So next one, there is no avatarika. Okay, we'll see the mantra. We'll read the mantra.
Tadetaditi manyante.
Anirdeshyam paramam sukham. Katham nutadvijaniyam. Kimubhati vibhati va. So the first line is, we broke it up. Tadetaditi manyante nirdeshyam paramam sukham. That avagraha is there. Manyante anirdeshyam. Tadetaditi manyante anirdeshyam paramam sukham katham nu tadvijaniyam kimubhati vibhativa. So this rishi who has conceived this mantra, so this man is wondering, will we be able to get that bliss? Will we be able to attain that sort of bliss? Kimubhati vibhativa. Will we be able to attain that thing? Will it dawn on us? Will that happiness dawn on us? Will it ever be experienced by us? So that is the mood of this particular mantra. The mood is tad etaditi manyante anirdeshyam paramam sukham tat etat. Tat means it is referring to the earlier shanti, tesham shantihi shashvati. It is referring to that shanti. The earlier mantra, it said tat sukham, tesham sukham shashvatam, isn't it? Sukham shashvatam, shantihi shashvati. So these things, they are referred to here. Tat etad iti manyante. What is said to be that tat? Tat is that Brahmananda. Tat etat, that is this. It is now, it is present here. So that is what is this saying. Tat, it is present here, it is there, it is with you. That is what it says. It is with you. Tat etad iti manyante. So people say like that. Iti manyante means people say like that. People means here we have to say wise people, wise men, they say like that. Tat etad iti manyante. Wise people say that Brahmanandam is with you. Tat etad iti manyante. What is that tat? Anirdeshyam paramam sukham. That paramam sukham. Paramam anirdeshyam sukham. That paramam and anirdeshyam are two adjectives for this sukham. Paramam. Paramam is that supreme. Paramam, and for which there is no comparison. For which there is no other. That is something which is unsurpassed, unequaled, unparalleled. So that is that paramam. Anirdeshyam. Nirdesha means to point out, to identify. This anirdeshyam means that which cannot be described, that which is indescribable, that which is beyond words. Anirdeshyam. Anirvachya, that is something which cannot be defined. Anirdeshyam paramam sukham. This indefinable supreme happiness, that bliss, is something which is with you. That is what people say. That is the meaning of first line. Tat anirdeshyam paramam sukham etad iti manyante. That supreme undefinable happiness is here. That is what wise people are saying. So that is the meaning. Then katham nu tad vijaniyam. Katham nu. How can I? Katham nu. Nu is a sort of nipata, what we say, avyaya or nipata. Basically to give that expression, how is it? How is it possible? How can I? So that sense. Katham nu tad vijaniyam. Aham katham vijaniyam. How am I able to know that? How will I be able to know that? Kimu bhati vibhati va. Kimubhati, will it ever dawn on me? Will I be ever able to experience that? Bhati, bha means bhanam. Bhanam is shining. Bha, bhaskara. What is the meaning of bhaskara? Bha karoti iti bhaskaraha. Bha means light. Bharata, what is the meaning of bharata? Bhayam rataha bharataha. Bha means say brilliance, their intelligence, buddhi. Buddhyam rataha, that is Bharata. In Bhagavad Gita, we come across this word several times. Hey Bharata, and what not. What is the meaning of Bharata? Bharata is Bhayam rataha. One who is interested in intelligence, one who is interested in buddhi, is that Bharata. That is the nature, that is the name of our country also, Bharata. The name of Bharata is That is what Bharata, one of the people who are interested in intelligence. Anyway, say here, Himu Bhati, Bha root is, Bha means brilliance, Bhati means it is shining. Here we are not, we should not think of physical light, we should think in a metaphorical sense. We should not see the physical light which is there, that sunshine which is outside. We have to see this in a metaphorical sense, Lakshana, metaphorical sense is Bhati means intelligence. Kimu Bhati, will it ever dawn on me? Will that happiness ever descend on me? Will it ever happen to me? Will I be able to experience it? So that is the meaning here. So, have you understood the mantra? Tat etaditi manyante katham nu tat vijaniyam. Aham katham vijaniyam means how will I be able to know that? Then kimu bhati vijaniyam, not able to know, experience. Vijnana and jnana, these two words we know, isn't it? Jnana is knowledge. Vijnana is experiencing. Then here, that this vijaniyam is from that word vijnana. How will I be able to experience it? So that is it. Kimu bhati vibhati va. Will it ever dawn on me? So that is the doubt. Next month, the next shloka is going to say, next mantra, yes, yes, it will dawn on you. You are that, it is going to say. So let us read the bhashyam.
Yattad atma vijnanam
sukham anirdeshyam nirdeshtum ashakyam paramam prakrushtam prakruta purusha vangmanasayoho agocharam agocharam api san
Nivruttaishanaha ye brahmanaha
te yattad.
We
will stop here. Okay. Yat tad atma vijnanam. That particular atma vijnana. That particular experience of that Brahman. Atma vijnanam is that experiencing that Brahman. Sukham. By experiencing that sukham, that bliss. How is that bliss? Anirdeshyam. Nirdeshtum ashakyam is that which cannot be defined, which cannot be described. Nirdeshtum ashakyam. Then paramam is prakrushtam, something which is supreme. There is nothing beyond that, prakrushta, that which is exalted, that which is very high. Then prakruta purusha vangmanasayoho agocharam. This is important. So this is something which cannot be seen by, which cannot be realized by this prakruta purushaha. Prakruta, what is the meaning of prakruta? The opposite of samskruta. Several times we have come across this word, Samskruta and Prakruta. There is what is called Samskrutam is a language, Prakrutam is another language. Samskrutam is that refined version of the language. Say even in our ordinary, in any society at any time, say there is a particular style in which literature is produced. There is another particular style which is used in common, by the common people. So what is called the gutter language, gutter English or gutter language. So this gutter language will be different from the language used by a writer or a poet. So this Samskruta is a refined, Prakruta is unrefined. So here in a philosophical, in the context of Vedanta, what is the meaning of Samskruta? You want to open it? The meaning of Samskruta here is, Those who have undergone this regimen of Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasana, that is a Samskruta mind. Prakruta Buddhi is those who have never bothered for the Upanishadic teaching, those who have never bothered to know what is Atman, those who have never bothered to know what is that Supreme Reality, and those who only see diversity, those who only want desires. So these are all the Prakruta Buddhis. So for all these Prakruta Buddhinam, for all these Prakruta Purusha, Vang Manasayoho Agocharam. So this thing is Agocharam. Agocharam is unseen, unperceived. Na Gocharam is Agocharam. Na Gocharam is Agocharam. That is unperceived by this Indriya, this Vak Manasayoho. It is not something which is in the cognizance of this Prakruta Purushas. It cannot be cognized, it cannot be realized by these people. Then who are those people? Vangmanasayoho agocharamapi, even though it is like that, agocharamapi san. Then nivruttaishanaha ye brahmanaha te, we have to read from here, yattadetat pratyakshameva iti manyante. Okay, then nivruttaishanaha, You see, this Prakruta man is just not able to comprehend it. On the other hand, there are the Samskruta Buddhayaha, Prakruta Buddhayaha, opposite to Samskruta Buddhayaha. These are the Nivruttaishanaha. These are the people who say that that bliss is here only. They say, yat, tat, etat, pratyakshameva. Pratyakshameva means, it is felt, it is realized by you. Iti manyante, they say that. They say, and then they hold. Manyante means they hold that this is something which is pratyaksham. So, let us see. Nivrutta eshanaha ye brahmanaha. Nivrutta eshanaha. Nivrutta plus eshanaha becomes nivrutta eshanaha. What is this eshana? We have come across this word earlier. Eshana. There are three types of eshanas. Putra eshana, vitta eshana, lokeshana. Putra eshana. That is to increase your progeny, increase your wealth, and then that line has to go on, and then that thing is that putra eshana. Then vitta eshana, having more and more wealth. Then lokeshana. Lokeshana is you want to be great in this society, or you want to in other terms, you want to go achieve Svargaloka, you want to achieve Goloka, you want to achieve Samadhar Loka, etc. by doing so many yajnas, yagas and all that. That again is Lokeshana. Lokeshana can be two ways. One is in this world to be regarded as a great man, to be honored as a very great man, to be recognized as a great man, that is one thing. In another sense, doing all these, performing all these yajnas, yagas, and then attain this loka, attain that loka, satya loka, all these lokas. So that is again lokeshana. So putraishana, vittaishana and lokeshana. The Upanishadic line is putraishanayascha, vittaishanayascha, lokeshanayascha, vyutthaya. Vyutthaya means having transcended, having gone above. Vyutthanam means going above. Vyutthaya brahmacharyam charanti. So those people who really desire this Brahman, they get rid of all these eshanas, putreshana, vitteshana, lokeshana, they abandon and then they transcend, they go beyond these three things and then brahmacharyam charanti. Brahmacharyam charanti means they will spend their time only meditating on the Brahman, on the nature of Brahman. Meditating means not simply closing your eyes and then doing some japam. This is Shravana Manana Nididhyasana, that in that sense meditation. Brahmacharyam charanti means that Shravana Manana Nididhyasana, that they do. So that is the meaning here. As Nivruttaishanaha ye Brahmanaha, those people who are really the seekers of Brahman. Brahmanaha here is seekers of Brahman. Te yat tad yetat. Yat tat yetat. That particular bliss is here and available now. Pratyaksham. Pratyaksham means it is there with you. You can perceive it, you can experience it. So that is it. Nivrutta means that which has devoid of yeshana is nivrutta yeshana. Nivrutta. Nirgataha vruttayaha. Ye nivrutta. Nivrutta means nirgataha vruttayaha. All these things have gone. So that thing, that thing is nivrutta. That is, it has disappeared. In their case, all those yeshanas have receded into background. So that is the meaning. So then, kathamnu
kena prakarena
tat sukham aham vijaniyam. So this rishi is wondering, in what manner? Kathamnu means in kena prakarena, in what manner? Tat sukham aham vijaniyam. How can I experience that sort of bliss? Then idam iti
atma buddhi vishayam
apadayayam
yatha nivruttaishanaha yatayah
nivrutta plus eshana becomes nivruttaishana yatayah. So idam iti atma buddhi vishayam apadayayam, that is, how can I also experience it as, yes, this it is, idam iti. Idam iti means, here it is this, iti. Atma buddhi vishayam katham apadayayam. How can I get into my own mind, get into my own experience. Atma buddhi vishayam is, buddhi vishayam is, that which comes to your experience is buddhi vishayam, buddhi gocharam. Atma buddhi vishayam apadayayam. How can I know that bliss? So that is the meaning here. Atma buddhi vishayam apadayayam. यथा निवृत्तैषणा यतयः, लाइक इन द केस ऑफ दोस यतयः, लाइक इन द केस ऑफ दोस सन्यासीस हू आर निवृत्तैषणास, दोस हू हैव ट्रांसेंडेड दिस थ्री एषणास, दिस एषणास आर ट्रांसेंडेड ओनली बाय द सन्यासीस, नॉट बाय अ संसारी. A samsari will be still lingering for that putreshana, viteshana, lokeshana, etc., etc. Of course, if he is a jnani, it is a different. Jnani karma, we have seen in Gita Bhashyam. Jnani karma, a person can be a jnani and he can be performing various activities. All those karmas, they become akarmas in his case. They will not produce any result. And an example also is given for that. What is that? Dagdhapata nyayena. Dagdhapata means, you throw a cloth into the fire. That cloth is totally burnt, but it still retains the shape. You just touch it and then you get the ashes only, and then the cloth no longer functions. So this man, jnani's functioning in the society is something like a dagdhapata. That is like a burnt paper or a burnt, not only cloth, paper also. Paper also, you see, it retains its shape and form. But the moment you touch it, it is just ash only. So like that, this man's activities will be seen, but then they will not affect this gentleman because he is not having that sense of I. That sense of I feeling has totally disappeared from him. So that is the meaning. So that nivruttaishanaha, yatha nivruttaishana, nivruttaishana yatayaha. Then kimutad bhati deepyate prakashatmakam tat. यतः असंबुद्धि यतः अस्मद् बुद्धिगोचरत्वेन विभाति विस्पष्टं दृश्यते किं वा न इति ओके ना वेदर यू कीप इट ऑर नॉट इट डजंट मैटर ओके किमु तद् भाति दीप्यते प्रकाशात्मकं तत् दैट पर्टिकुलर थिंग दैट प्रकाशात्मकं प्रकाश मीन्स here for these words prakasha and bha etc etc we should not take in the sense of physical shining, physical light, so many lumens, we should not consider in that sense. So this particular light is in so many lumens and then the higher light, sun's light, is in so many lumens. We should not compare. That is not the thing, physical, not the physical light. It is that chaitanya we are seeing, that particular chaitanya only we are referring to and not physical light. Then kimu tad bhati deepyate, will it ever shine on me, will it ever dawn on me? Bhati kimu tad bhati deepyate prakashatmakam tat. Prakashatmakam means that which is of the nature of intelligence, that which is of the nature of consciousness or chaitanya. So that is it. Kimu tad bhati tat yataha asmad buddhi gocharatvena. Asmad buddhi gocharatvena means, will it ever be realized by my buddhi? It is that buddhi which is going to realize it, isn't it? Mana, this jnanam also, this mana eva manushyanam sadhanam bandhamokshayoho, isn't it? Through this mind only, by purifying this mind, this susamskurta buddhi is only able to grasp it, isn't it? Is able to understand it. So, buddhi gocharatvena katham vibhati vispashtam drushyate. Will I be able to see it in a very clear way? Vispashtam. Spashtam is very, very clear manner. In a very clear way, will I be able to understand it? Will I be able to experience it? Kim ubhati vispashtam drushyate kimva na? Or will I not be able to do that? So, that is it. Then, next, atra uttaramidam bhati cha vibhati cha iti. Katham. So the answer is bhaticha vibhaticha. If only you are sincere, it will shine on you, it will shine brilliantly on you, it will shine clearly on you. That is it. Vibhati. That is vispastam drushyate. That is very clearly you can see that, very clearly you can experience it. So that is the meaning. Katham, how? So let us see the next mantra. Natatra suryo bhati na chandra tarakam. Nema vidyuto bhanti kutoyam agnihi. Tameva bhantam anubhati sarvam. Tasya bhasa sarvamidam vibhati. Okay, this is again a very popular mantra, in the sense that this mantra is recited when you light the lamp in front of the god. In fact, in different sampradayas, of course. In one sampradaya, they say, what is that mantra? When you light the lamp, Uddipya Svajata Vedopagnan Nirutim Mama, that mantra is recited in some places. In some places, this mantra also is recited. Natatra Suryo Bhati Nachandra Tarakam Nema Vidyuto Bhanti. This is also recited in some other traditions. So, this mantra is a very fairly popular mantra. So popular that it is recited every time you sit for puja in front of the god, your whatever favorite deity you have, you sit in front of the deity, and then when you light the lamp, this is the mantra recited. So what does it say? Na tatra suryo bhati na chandra. The physical meaning, the literal meaning, let us see first. Na tatra suryah bhati. Tatra means there means where, with respect to that Brahma, with respect to that Brahma Ananda, with respect to that Brahma Chaitanya, with respect to that Brahma Chaitanya, tatra suryaha na bhati. Sun does not shine there. Sun becomes inapplicable there. Na chandra tarakam. This moon, chandra tarakam means moon and stars. Combinedly it is called chandra tarakam, jointly. This moon and stars, they also do not shine. They do not illuminate. The sun does not illuminate, the moon and the stars also do not illuminate. Then, Nema Vidyuto Bhanti. Nema is Na plus Ima. Na and Ima becomes Nema. Ima means these. Imaha. Imaha Vidyutaha. Vidyutaha means this lightnings which you see in the sky, that is called Vidyut. Vidyut, now we should not take the modern meaning electricity. We should take that the old meaning only. Vidyut. Vidyut means the lightning. The lightning which you see, that is called Vidyut. Stanitam garjitam ghoram. There is something in Amarakosha. Anyway, this Vidyut means that lightning. Vidyut, Vidyutav, Vidyutaha. Vidyutaha is the plural. Ima Vidyutaha, that is these lightnings. Mema Vidyutaha, you can't see this in the light of this Vidyut, in the light of these lightnings. Nema na ima Vidyutaha bhanti, kutoyam agnihi, kutaha ayam agnihi. What to talk of this Agni? Surya cannot illuminate, Chandra Tarakam cannot illuminate this. And then these lightnings cannot illumine this. What to talk of this small Agni which is there on the ground? These are all heavenly bodies. When all these heavenly bodies are not able to illumine, what to talk of this Agni which is there on earth? So that is the meaning. Nema kutoyam agnihi. Tam eva bhantam anubhati sarvam. All these things, sarvam means all, anubhati, all these things, they shine after that Brahman only. With that Brahma's light only, all other things are shining. Tameva bhantam. Tam bhantam means following that which is shining, all other things, they shine. Tameva bhantam. Bhantam, that is in Dvitiya Vibhakti. Tam bhantam anubhati sarvam. Sarvam anubhati. All other, they anubhati. Following that which is shining, all other things, they shine. So that is the meaning. Tasya bhasa sarvam idam vibhati. Because of that light, all other things are able to shine. Because of that shine, taking that brilliance, all other things are shining. So that is the physical level meaning. So as I said, the shine or light, we should not take in the physical sense. We should not take in the physical sense. We should not take in the sense of Chaitanya in the name, that is consciousness. We have to take the meaning that all this refers to Chaitanya or consciousness or ability to understand, ability to see, ability to perceive, ability to cognize. Ultimately, it is a question of who is the seer and what is the seen. Ultimately, who is the drashta and what is the drushyam? What is this drushyam? Is the sun a drashta or a drushyam? Is moon a drashta, is a see, observer or the observed, or the seer or the seen? And this Agni, is it the perceiver or the perceived? Then Vidyutaha, all these lightnings, etc., all these things, are they the drashta or drushyam? All these things are drushyam only, that is the observed, the seen. So these are all the things which are seen. The seer is only one, that is that Brahman. So the ultimately that is what we have to see, not in terms of brilliance and light and whatnot. So let us close this. You still have some time?
Yes, 5 minutes.
5 minutes. 5 minutes. I will just briefly refer to. Then okay, we'll briefly refer to one Brahmanam, which is in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. This Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, now and then we have to refer to, because that is something like an ocean. That is something like an ocean which has say reverberations in all other say Upanishads. Or rather, all other Upanishads, they have reverberation in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. So in that Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, there is one chapter called Jyotir Brahmanam. One particular chapter, the chapter's names are Brahmanam there. So there it is, what is called Jyotir Brahmanam. Jyoti means light. Light means Chaitanyam, intelligence. Jyotir Brahmanam. What is this intelligence? So that is the question. The basic question, either in science or in Vedanta. In Vedanta, right from the time of Upanishads, right from the Vedas, the question has been, what is matter and what is mind? What is, Jada and what is Chetana? Jada is matter, Chetana is mind, isn't it? What is matter and what is mind? Who is the Drashta and what is the Vishayam and what is the Vishayi? These are all various words. Vishaya is an object. Vishayi is the person who sees the object. Vishaya means a drushyam. Vishayi is a drashta. Vishaya means the seer, the seen. Vishayi is the seer. So, druk, drushya, drushyam and druk. So, these are all different words which we have to remember. If you come across new words like vishaya, vishayi, we should not be confused. We should not be, frightened. Vishaya is an object. Vishayi is the person who cognizes that object. So like that, drushyam and druk. So here, in that Jyotir Brahmana, there is a discussion. Jyotir Brahmana, the context is, Rishi Yajnavalkya, we know. Rishi Yajnavalkya goes to the king's court. The king is again a very wise king, King Janaka. So King Janaka, he himself is a Brahmagyani. So whenever these people, all these great rishis come, he not only gives them some money, but he also discusses with them something about the nature of Brahman. There the question comes as to what is it that is behind all this Chaitanya? What is it that illumines? What is it that gives you this thinking capacity? So the discussion, the flow of discussion is in this manner. So he says, okay, what is it that gives light? So it is the sun. Okay, when the sun is not there, when it is in the night, then what is it that gives light? It is the moon or stars. So, okay, when sun, moon, stars, all those are not there, then what is it that gives light? It is the Agni. Agni, it is the gives light. When Agni also is not there, and when there is such pitch darkness, where there is no Agni also to your aid, and where you are not able to see your own hand, then what is it that enables you to see or perceive? It is your Vag Jyoti. Vak means voice, your own voice or sound, let us say sound. So that sound is, the sound itself acts like a jyoti. Jyoti means light. Light means that which enables you to cognize. So here, for all this light, you take it as that which enables you to cognize. You take the general meaning. Jyoti should not be taken as light. Jyoti is that which enables you to cognize, perceive, to know. That which enables you to know. So what is it that enables you to know in that pitch darkness? Voice. Suppose you are in some very, very total pitch darkness where you are not able to see. Then you call out to your friend, hey, where are you? Then he says, yeah, here I am. So then you see that sense of direction and you also estimate the distance and then you catch up with him. Isn't it? So vak, that is the sound, acts as a jyoti. Or some dog barks and then you just estimate where exactly you are and then you go near or go away, whatever it is. So walk, functions in that thing. So this, when you say light and walk, you are only not referring to these two senses only. Here we have referred to sense of eye and sense of hearing. You have to take the other senses also. Smell, sense of taste, sense of sparsha, all these things also we have to take. you should not refer to only one sense, that is eye. You should take into consideration all the five senses. Okay, if the time is over, we'll continue in the next class, this mantra, because this Jyotir Brahmana, we slightly go into details. And then how this whole thing has to be explained. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.